celebrations of life. Stay in the moment, stay in the present. That's why it's called a present. It is a gift, and I extend my gift of aromatherapy to you. Hi, my name is Delilah Wright Grayer, and I am grateful for Miss Fikisha to allow me to be a part of her show. Actually, I want to tell you something. Do you know the best universal secret is, guess what? It is, aroma is therapy. It is actually very therapeutic. It is an ancient art. And guess what? Everything that grows in our lives, that we thrive for and that survive, is grown from the root up. And a lot of the essences and in ingredients from the aromatherapy or from the oils of essence, they are derived from seeds, flowers, plants, bark, trees, grasses, and nuts. And this is a particular workbook that I have written. It has a rainbow of treasures, and there's all majestic kinds of things. Actually, the subtitle is called The Journey to the Sweeter Side of Life. There is a journey to the sweeter side of life. And guess where the journey begins? It begins right here. It's an internal and intrinsic healing. And the beautiful thing about the scents, which is the oils of essence, which we title today, Aromatherapy. That phrase was coined by Dr. Gattafossi, who was a scientist in France. And 1927, he started working and resurging the whole energy around aromatherapy. However, as he was working in his laboratory, something kind of not really drastic happened. But with all the chemicals he was mixing up, his lab blew up. So he tells the story about how he ran out and rolled in the grass. And when he came back, he had two vats of lavender. And he put his arms in the vats, and he had second-degree burns that totally disappeared. So I am also going to talk about some of the great and very popular kinds of essences, which would just be perfect. But one thing about the essential oils, they're called essential because they are necessary, very absolutely necessary. And they have wonderful healing powers. They awaken the senses. They heal the body, the mind, and even a part of the emotions. Very, very stimulating. So at this point, when you talk about options and alternatives in life, if there's millions of people on the planet, we must realize there are so many ways that we can do other things. There's not just a way. But to remind you of this, the botanical plants was the first medicine that was used. See, we now are in a movement. We're in a movement of green consciousness, a culture that wants pure essences of all things, and being very, very conscientious about our healing methods, our options, our alternatives, and what happens to us in terms of the best, having the best. Some of the ground rules with the essential oils are very interesting. Because when you go to a health food store, not any other store, you want the therapeutic, you want the pure oils. They will always have a pinhole, which means that when you turn the bottle upside down, there will be a drop. And once you have that, you are not to touch the top of the bottle because it diffuses the energy. So now I'm going to have to just take a quick personal break. And what I usually do is put the peppermint on my lips. And it's also very, very refreshing, absolutely refreshing. The one ground rule that is very important is that people that have epilepsy or that are expecting should not deal with the oils at all because they can be very provoking. See, we are attracted to certain smells and the olfactory. Actually, the sense that we smell, it's the only sense that we have that has contact with the outer world. So it's very important that we follow at least a few of the ground rules. And those are also listed in my book. Now, how do we actually use these oils of essence? You can massage, have a gentle massage, or what they call a more penetrating massage. You can use them in the bath, but let me say something about the bath. Make sure you have a good drain, and also that you will be using the essential oils no more than maybe 5 or 6 drops. And then guess what? You're going to use with that, you're going to use what is called a carrier oil. With all oils of essence, you should have a carrier oil. And a carrier oil is the oil that helps penetrate the essences in the body much quicker and stimulates the brain and goes through the bloodstreams and helps assist you in getting ready to make some changes around the physical part of your person. Then we have what is called a diffuser. Now, a diffuser, this is interesting because some of the commercial, like Johnson & Johnson, or some of the commercial kinds of products, they use diffusers. When you see the spray, that's considered a diffuser. When you have the plug-ins, but you can go to the health food store and get a plug-in, and it will actually, you plug it in the socket, electrical socket, and it'll have like a little square gauze, and you put whatever fragrance you want on it. My recommendation is lavender, because lavender is so powerful. But I will get to the lavender piece in a minute. When you plug it in, I would not recommend that you use peppermint, because then your life might go real crazy, exciting, because it's so stimulating and it's so penetrating, and it's actually, it can really help you move along and be very motivated. And along with that, we have, this is a diffuser. So you pour your oil in here, and this is a carrier oil. This is made of sesame, olive oil, and jojoba. Some people call it jojoba because it's spelled J-O-J-O-B-A, but this is what a part of that is. And then you pour it in here, and then you would light your candle to keep it warm. Also, you can use a humidifier, and you would put in 2 or 3 drops, mainly lavender, especially if someone has asthma or needs to sleep, and or has a cold, eucalyptus could be used. And that would also penetrate a wonderful fragrance and a healing fragrance in the room. You could put oils of essence on cotton if you have young ones or babies. You would use, again, lavender. That's how powerful it is. I'll begin to tell you the story about it in a moment. And with the lavender, you could put cotton balls, place it on their dresser so they would actually have that. And then I want to move to the sprays. You can just buy your own bottle or use a, never plastic for oils of essence. They're too concentrated and the fragrances are strong, and you want it to be able to have a certain age, a length, for a length of time. So you would get an atomizer or a spray bottle, as you would call it, and spray your own, make your own deodorizer. You can put healing essences on your body, in your hair, whatever suits you. You could also use and make your own lotions, or you could put oil in here. One of the things that I've recommended, someone asked me about what is really great for your skin. So you can put in a lotion that doesn't have a fragrance. You could add frankincense and myrrh and sandalwood. Those are the woodsy, the oil trees. So I will talk about that one too. Now, the other piece that I want to go to is when we think about changing our life and healing, we must realize the benefit of being able to explore how flexible and adaptable the brain is. The brain, the neural pathways in the brain can change just like that. So a lot of times your thinking can make it so. You can heal from being well to sick, and the very thing that makes you sick can make you well. It's a matter of being able to transform your paradigm, cognitive ability, their ability to think and perceive and visualize it different. How great is visualization when you want to heal, you want your life to be better, you want things to change? This is a true story. A friend of mine who was a doctor, he was operating on a woman and she went into cardiac arrest. Now, when we think about insight and perception, some of us take in things visually. I'm a visual person. Some of us auditorial and some tactile. But however, I want you to listen to this because as the doctor's telling me the story, later on, this woman, she begins to tell the story. And she said she looked down on the surgical table and she could actually see herself. And she noticed on the peripheral of the room that she was in, she saw her family and she heard them call code blue. And she said she looked around the room and she saw the doctor. And the doctor had the same name as her husband. She said, and I looked at the anesthesiologist and he had on mixed match socks. But from a distance, and you can tell how old this story is, she said, wow, that must be what is called a beehive hairdo. But the dynamic of the story is that this woman was blind from birth. So how powerful was vision? Very, very powerful. If you drive somewhere, that's how you got there. But the real deal how you got there is to see it. So we want to see a change. So when you're talking about change, it has a lot to do with the belief systems. And there is something called epigenetic, which I want to mention because it's very important. And all of this is in the book. Epigenetic is like an imprint. It is an imprint of our language, verbal and nonverbal. It is also what we believe. So when we're in certain transgenerational patterns and we talk about an illness, a disorder, or a disease, often we must be very careful because in the epigenetic code, the triggers and the drama of it, they can be changed into the genetic system. So remember how important. Epigenetic is the imprint of our memories, our belief systems, our triggers, and our dramas in our lives, verbal or nonverbal. But however, what happens is the genetic system captures this information and it is passed on generationally. So if you have the belief that you're going to get this because someone in your family or your parents had it, then you also have a right to change. And that's another interesting thing about the oils of essence, because the oils of essence was our original ancient medicine. And I think about birthright. See, we all must realize that we do have a birthright. We have a right to be here, a right to be loving, a right to be taken care of. And we have a right to heal. And so the belief system has a lot to do with that. I want to mention a few of the most popular scents, the fragrances. Some of them are just so soothing and just are quiet. And some are just absolutely perky, alert, and just trying to even get centered with it. So the first one I'd like to share is the lavender. And the lavender was so powerful from Dr. Gadafusi. It was so powerful that it was used in World War I and II for first and second degree burns. And if someone has asthma or either hyperactive children, because it's the one oil that is so multi-leveled, multifaceted, and so universal. And believe it or not, it has a cosmic soul mate. And that cosmic soul mate is peppermint. That is the cosmic soul mate. But let me share a little more about the lavender. The lavender is, the healing properties are phenomenal. If you have insomnia or tension,